And welcome to a very special Long Live the Queen playthrough. My name is Anna Mardal, and today I have figured out how to use the cheat console. So we're going to do something a little bit differently than usual, and I'm just actually going to dive right in. You'll notice that usually we start on the front page. I haven't done that this time because I've actually done some pre-setup work, but we are on week one with Elodie being very sad. Here's her mood. I haven't altered that. What I have done is when I hit escape and go into preferences and go into video settings, the debugging console is hidden here. And here is where you put in code. I'm not gonna do all of it for you guys here because it would have been very boring for you, I assure you, but the codes are easily listed on the Long Live the Queen Wikia under cheat codes. So real easy to find. I'll try to put a link in this description. And what I have done is I've gone through and I'm gonna max out all of our skills and I've unlocked all the outfits with the exception of the Lumen skills. And I'll get to that in a second. But what I haven't done, and in fact, I hit enter even though I haven't put anything in. Here are our skills right now. I haven't done Faith yet. I'm gonna do that right now so I can show everybody how we do it. So I'm gonna go back to preferences, video settings, debugging console. So I'm gonna say meditation equals 100. And you do need to put the spaces around the equal sign. And then I have to do it again, meditation underscore equals 100. Why did I have to do that twice? One of them deals with your permanent value and the other one deals with your effective temporary value, which our temporary value is altered by things like what clothes we're wearing. So I've just set both of them to 100. Now I'm going to do the same thing with divination equals 100. And divination underscore equals 100. And then we have lore equals 100 and lore underscore equals 100. Not all the skills are intuitive. Like voice is actually voice underscore skill because voice was a reserved name whenever Hanako made this game and we're putting in cheat codes. So you do want to go to the wiki to look at the cheat codes. I hit enter again. It says execution successful. We're gonna say done for now. So if I go under skills, look at that. So it hit me the other day that what Long Live the Queen really needs, and Hanako, if you're out there listening, this is my opinion. What it really needs is it needs like a new game plus option where when you finish the game, you can roll over to the next game and keep all your skills. Like that would be super cool. And eventually you'd have this maxed out, obviously, princess. I wanted to do this because there's a lot of story stuff that we never get to see because I'm so busy and there's a lot of game stuff because I'm so busy maxing out, you know, Faith because that's really important that I never ever do like medicine or history, hardly ever. So I wanted to actually be able to go through and have all this cool, fun stuff like athletics without having to worry about the fact that if I don't get my Lumen up, then I'm gonna die horribly. So the mental headcanon explanation I have for this is that Elodie has actually been trained and, schooled, okay, up to this point. So she's got all these skills. You'll notice I didn't max out Lumen skills. I could. I'm choosing not to because it should be really easy to pick up early after we've had all these maxed out to begin with. But in my head, she hasn't learned any Lumen skills because she doesn't have a Lumen crystal yet. The other thing I did use cheat codes for was I went ahead and unlocked all the outfits again except Lumen. So we've got boarding school outfit. We've got the tea dress outfit, which is very nice and lovely. We've got, oops, wrong button. We've got the scholar's gown, which honestly I love. I should keep her in that more often. I love the little rose at her waist and the rose in her hair and the feather pen. And I may actually just keep her in that because I love that outfit. And we never get to see it. We've got the nurse's gown for medicine, which is nice. We've got the military uniform with her little epaulettes. We've got a tabard, which you also, I don't think, ever see in my playthroughs. This is for weapons, which is just adorable. She looks like a little squire. We've got the hunting coat for if she's got horses and dogs and falcons. We have the coronet outfit, which is very pretty and I'm fond of. Toga, which is honestly one of my favorites. It's so comfy. It's so cute looking. I love the little gold vines. We've got the cat suit. We've got the economics tuxedo, which still kind of cracks me up. We've got the tutu for agility. We have her exercise gear for athletics, which is another one you rarely see her in. And we've got the faith priestess robes. And again, so that's all the outfits except Lumen. And I'm going to put her back in the scholar's gown. Oh, and she's got glasses. Oh my gosh. And I'm going to go ahead and save my game here. And we're going to call this cheating too. And you'll notice that because I've used the debugger, there's now a little thing here that says debugger to warn you that this is a cheating game. So I have never gone through with all the skills and ability to do skill checks. So to me, this is super cool because even fresh off the bat, we can do stuff. So I just want to have fun because it's been a while since I've gone through this game and had fun as opposed to, what was that? Blah, 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 blah. Scholar scan. As opposed to, working towards some constant end goal that was always in mind. I don't know what we're going to do. We could do anything we want. So let's do anything we want. And really, I'm going to be honest, this is a very selfish playthrough. This is for me, because I've had like a really long day. And I figured I might as well get a video out of it. And now it's for all of us. So, classes. We can take anything. And hopefully it won't crash because we're all full up. So I'm going to go ahead and take like composure and elegance and see what happens. And it should say, you have nothing more to learn about these things. Yep. What's all that noise outside? Who's here? Oh, it's my cousins and my aunt and uncle. Darling, we were so terribly sorry to hear about your mother, Fidelia. She's 36. My God, she's as old as some of the people we can marry. That just hit me. Thank you. Okay, there's all of our peoples. You look well, niece. Hi, Lottie. I haven't seen you in ages. Will you be staying long? Mommy said we'd be here all month. Maybe we'll have some time to talk later. Okay, so, oh my gosh, we can do anything we want. There's a ball we can attend. I know the hunting is from unlocking animals. I know the barracks is from unlocking weapons or military or both. Sports is from unlocking either athletics or agility or both. I've never seen this attend ball option, not once. And I promised myself I would save a lot because I want to see everything. We could talk to our father. We could visit Lottie. Let's go talk to our dad. Dad, can we talk? I'm sorry. Your uncle and I have things to do. Maybe another time. Oh, well, screw that. I'm not doing that. That was sad. This is what I'm talking about. This is going to be the safe, scummiest thing I have ever done because I want to see as much as we can. So let's visit Charlotte instead. I love this room. It's so much bigger than mine back home. You should visit more often. It's awful that the only time I get to see you is something like this. I know your brother and sister are still too young, but why haven't you come to school?
My mother worries about me. She doesn't think anywhere but home is safe.
I understand. I'm probably not going to be allowed to leave this castle until my birthday.
But at least we can have fun together here.
Aw, that was sweet. Okay, so our mood right now is afraid because we bumped up depression. And it doesn't really matter because we're maxed out of everything. And I could have neutralized our mood, but I wasn't really sure how to, so I didn't. It was going to be more trouble than I wanted to go to whenever I can just do things on the weekends. So classes, we can do anything. I'm just going to have us doing meditation, even though we've maxed it out. The only thing that this makes me sad is that y'all don't get to see the, descriptions of all the learning stuff. I almost want to like fire up the wiki and read them all to you because they're really good stuff, but I won't in this one, probably.
What's that commotion outside? Father? What's going on?
I have come to pay my respects in honor of your mother.
Oh, we have all the information. Because prefers the company of women is something you get in the intrigue. Cool!
You have no respect or honor. It's because of you and your powers that my wife is dead.
What?
I am a lumen, as was she. And like every lumen, I am willing to give my life, if necessary, to protect our domain. Your line has been traitors for 200 years. I won't have you corrupting my daughter. That is for the Crown Princess to decide. Elodie, your mother trusted me, and I have much to teach you. So I'm going to go ahead and let her stay.
I want to hear what she has to say.
She stays.
I love her willful face.
As you wish.
Okay, so wow, let's save again. Week 2. We've got a lot of options, and I want to see all of them. Dad, what really happened to Mom?
She was a lumen, a magic user. It was meant to be in reserve to defend our domain, but she insisted on... You don't need to hear that. She used magic. It drained her strength. She thought it was harmless, and it wasn't. Eventually, her heart just stopped. That's why I don't want you involved in it.
Oh. So what does Charlotte say? What do you know about lumens? Why? Dad was really angry at the Duchess of Rasul. Mommy says people are scared of lumens because they're jealous. There used to be lots of them in Nova, but there aren't anymore. I don't know why. Maybe someone burned them.
So that's interesting because Charlotte's mom is a lumen. So, you know, Mommy says that people are just jealous. This is kind of training her to... Okay, so we already know what Juliana's going to say. So I'm actually going to go talk to Father and get the information that she was a lumen and she used it and it was dangerous and everything. I don't actually... We're in week 3, yes. Y'all got to keep me up. But it says week 2. We're going into week 3. Okay, that's right. So classes, again, we can do anything. I like this Elodie who has been trained properly.
He loves me, he loves me not. Lottie, do you have a boyfriend?
Not really, I just like to play with the flowers.
All of a sudden, the Duchess of Ursul rushes into the garden and points a sword at you. No, not at you, at your feet? Princess, don't move. So I'm gonna go ahead and look down. You look down where her sword is pointing. There's a snake in the grass. You can't help it. You squeak and jump back. The snake tenses and prepares to strike.
No! Oh no. I thought we could hold still. I didn't mean for Lottie to get sick. So she's gonna get hurt. Well, it is what it is. Your cousin pushes you aside and the snake's fangs sink into her leg.
Lottie!
Too late, Juliana swings her sword and cuts off the snake's head.
What is going on out here?
Your daughter's been bitten by a milk viper. They're poisonous. Get an herbalist right away. I will treat my daughter. I certainly can't trust anyone here to keep her safe.
I'm sorry. I don't feel good.
We will be returning home to Mirva immediately. Your aunt has a point. Milk vipers are not native to this area. That snake should never have been here. Someone may have tried to kill you.
Will Charlotte be okay?
I don't know.
So, wow, that was exciting and scary. Let's go talk to Father again.
Daddy?
He sighs, rubbing his fingers over his forehead.
What is it?
I love you. He looks at you without speaking, and you begin to feel bad for bothering him with your silly feelings. Then he stands and puts his arms around you.
I love you too.
For this moment, you are safe and happy. Shut up, you're crying.
Ah, oh, it's so much cooler when we can just go through and I don't have to worry about every single class.
The castle seems quieter with Charlotte and Emery and Zara and their parents gone. It's certainly not empty, though. It seems like we get more servants every day. I was so worried about Charlotte after that snake bit her.
Poison success! There's no known cure for milk viper venom. Many people just die.
But her mother says she's okay, so I guess it turned out all right. Maybe she has a guardian angel.
All right, so I'm curious. This is me being curious. If we go to the treasure first, will we find... we didn't. I was wondering if we'd find the crystal.
What is it you wanted to teach me?
First, I need to know if you have your mother's crystal.
A lumen crystal? No.
Oh, we missed like lore tests because we didn't put her in jail.
Well, it's okay. It's fine.
The royal crystal has been passed down from ruler to ruler for generations. It belongs to you now, except that the king may be keeping it from you.
Do you have a crystal?
Of course. She holds out her hands. Light flickers above her bosom, and then with a shower of sparkles, something takes shape. You reach out to touch it, and it dissolves into nothing.
Oh.
It belongs to me. No one can take it from me until I die. You need to find the crystal that belongs to you.
One of the maids approaches for your attention. My lady, couriers have arrived from the Duke of Sedna.
Oh wow, Alice is only 18. I did not know that.
Sedna, that's in Talais, the domain to our southeast. They have brought you a letter and a gift. Condolences on the death of, deeply regret, best wishes. Oh, what a beautiful necklace.
It might not be appropriate for me to wear a man's gift in public, though. People would think it meant something.
So, we won't wear it. It's important to maintain the proper image.
So if we go visit Juliana... Oh, this is a whole new conversation.
How do I find my lumen crystal?
Your father probably knows what happens to it.
What if he destroyed it?
They can't be destroyed. He could throw it away, but then someone else might find it. No, he'll keep it safe.
But if it's mine, it wouldn't matter if someone else found it.
It's attuned to you, but you haven't bonded with it yet. If it found a compatible host, someone who was like you in some way, it could bond to them.
We may end up having to cheat our values because I don't want to miss a check just because we got all these conversations. Maybe I should go back. No, I'm not going to.
As you are walking, you spot a familiar figure in the palace gardens. It's the Duchess of Rasul. Maybe I should go and say hello.
Then you notice that seated beside her is a woman in the robes of a priestess. They are very close together, their hands gently touching as they speak. Looks like she's busy. You turn and walk in a different direction, so as not to disturb them. At that moment, you notice something unusual. It looks like someone just left the palace grounds by going over the hedge. Was that a servant, a thief, or an assassin?
We have never, ever had the skills to go after this person. Not once.
Climb up to look over the hedge. You clamber up a nearby tree to get a better view. There! You see a boy, a bit older than you, hurrying away from the palace grounds as he munches on an apple. Your apples! He was stealing your apples! It's too late to catch him now, but you will remember. Dad, what happened to Mom's lumen crystal?
It's in a safe place.
Can I have it?
No.
But it's mine!
Meddling with magic killed your mother. I don't want that to happen to you. Once you're crowned queen, I can't stop you from doing anything you want. But for now, you are still a child.
Okay. We never caught the apple guy before. As you are walking up the stairs, a maid comes running down holding a towering pile of linen. You gracefully step aside and let her pass.
So, just out of curiosity, can we just guess that it's in the treasury?
There it is. You overwhelm the guards with facts and figures, explaining that you need to... But...
I'm gonna kick myself in the foot here. We'll go to Juliana first. How would we know it was in the treasury?
My father says I can't have the crystal until I'm queen, so we just have to wait.
There may not be time to wait. The world is filled with dangers, and you need the powers of a lumen to fight them. You can't begin training until you've bonded with your crystal.
Well, what am I supposed to do about it?
The crystal is probably held under guard in the royal treasury. You are the princess. You should be able to find your way in. So I'll try to find a way.
We need to get willful, though. How are we doing on that? Well, it would probably help if we weren't so afraid. All right.
There is a man here to see you. He wishes crown funding for a project of his. Remember, the treasury is not unlimited. If you choose to invest, you will have less money to work with later.
Your Royal Highness, I have a plan to print books using metal letters which can be moved and reused. I need to borrow 875 lassi to assemble the metal and a factory to mold and cast the type.
If it really works, that could be an important invention.
We would be happy to invest in your venture.
All right, you overwhelm the guards with facts and figures. This is the crystal that will make you a lumen. It would be nice if we could stop being afraid.
Okay, Banyan shows up. So we have that he's single and unsuccessfully romanced Juliana, Duchess of Rasul.
Your Highness, my sympathies for your loss. Even after all these years, I sometimes forget that my own mother will never be coming back.
Thank you.
However, I must call for your aid. The Ixionite occupation of the country of Ibrian has gone on for too long. Now is the time to push back.
His sister, the Duchess of Hellas, started the trouble in Ixion 4 years ago, so they invaded his territory as payback. We have plenty of troops, so it shouldn't be that hard to drive them out if we want to make a fight of it.
There must be a peaceful way to settle this. I will send for diplomats of Ixion and to try and come to some arrangement.
Thank you, Your Highness. If I might say so, you are looking particularly lovely this day. I hope you will think fondly of me.
Is he flirting with me? He's almost as old as my father.
Okay, let's go visit Juliana. I got it! What do I do now?
Pick up the crystal with your bare hands. Press it against your chest, over your heart, and say, illuminate.
Oh, that's new. Is that from talking to Dad? Is that from lore? We can ask about the risks. Oh, it is from talking to Dad. Is this dangerous? My father said that using magic can kill you.
Bonding with a crystal is not dangerous. Using magic can be dangerous, but that is why I'm here to train you.
My mother was trained, wasn't she?
Yes.
My father said she used too much magic,
and over time it built up and killed her. Your father means well, but he is not a lumen. I have drawn power many times over many years, and I am unharmed.
Then what did happen to my mother?
I don't know.
Oh my god, you can accuse her?
I think you know more than you're saying. My father blames you for her death. What did you do?
I did nothing because I was not here. That is my fault. I did not know she was in danger. I was not here to help her. I never thought of Fidelia as fragile. I believed she would outlive me. I expected to die in her service. I do not believe that magic had anything to do with her death. But I will never know because I was not here. But now I am.
I'm sorry.
Then, if you understand, take up the crystal and let us begin.
Oh. I'm not a big Juliana fan. I take her to task a lot in my videos, but that was heartbreaking.
She feels responsible for not being there to help. Oh. And Tagami killed your mother. Or he claims he did, and he probably did. From afar, with his magic. But you don't get that information unless he, like, kills your father and taunts you about it. And we're not gonna do that.
Wow! The priestess here is a friend of mine. I will come to your lessons in the faith and train you to use your powers.
Current mood afraid. So we really need to get angry. Okay, we can get angry. We can Hulk out. Okay. Go, go, classes.
The representative from Ixion is here. Be careful. No one wants to give up prizes that they have won.
You have the full support of my sister and myself, Your Highness.
Let's just get this over with.
Hellas and Marie are neighboring duchies. Together, the siblings Bryn and Banyan govern most of Southern Nova.
Your Royal Highness, thank you for granting me this audience. I am sure we can come to an amicable agreement.
Let bygones be bygones, no? We will forget about your unprovoked attacks on us, and you will transfer the rights to this little province.
It was the Duchess of Hellas who tried to take over part of Ixion's territory without the support of my mother, the Queen. We can be good neighbors again without any lives being lost. Ixion wants us to be good neighbors to the north because they're always fighting with Terax, their neighbor to the south.
So we've got a lot of options now. We can surrender the province. We can offer money. Because we have such good economics, we can drive a really hard bargain. But I'm going to offer to punish the Duchess of Hellas.
We appreciate that you feel wronged. One of our subjects attempted to instigate a rebellion in your territory. However, she did not have our approval for these actions. If you withdraw your troops, we will punish her.
Your Highness!
That is the fair solution. You have no right to invade us because of her actions.
What manner of punishment were you considering?
So we're going to command her to marry an Ixionite. She will marry an Ixionite lord of your choosing.
I will not! You will if you say it, if I say you will, or I'll take your title away.
Her heirs will be of your blood, in a peaceful union that benefits us both.
Very well. We accept this arrangement.
Once he leaves, you take the Duchess of Hellas aside. You have to marry someone, even if you don't like men. You need an heir, quickly. With a foreign husband, you'll have fewer problems if you divorce him after having a child.
Very well.
I feel kind of bad about that, because it's not cool to force people to marry other people. But I also think that It was a clever solution. I just want to see what the ball is. Gives you a chance to interact with the nobility in a less stressful environment. Huh. I have no idea what opens that. We're going to visit Juliana, though. Sorry, I've reloaded.
There's something I don't understand.
What is it?
Magical powers are connected to lumen crystals, right?
That is correct.
But I can make myself glow by concentrating the right way. And I did that even before I got the crystal.
Let me see. You concentrate and your skin begins to glimmer. You're right. It's not proper magic. It's something else.
Is that bad?
I sense no danger. Ignore it. It's a distraction.
There are a million magical secrets I don't know, but I'm trying to learn. This one affects me personally. I need to know what's causing it.
Very well. If I had to guess, I suspect it has something to do with your mother's powers. She was already a lumen when she bore you. Some small trickle of that energy may have passed into you.
So the daughter of an active lumen might have strange power.
It's hardly a power. It's a quirk. It's not worth wasting time on.
Willful face! So that's good because it helps our magic classes.
Boom. Look at that. There are reports that a Keithong has been sighted leaving the Old Forest.
The Old Forest? That's the area by Cathry Lake where the capital was until it was destroyed by monsters. What's a Keithong?
A beast with the body of an enormous golden cat, a sharp beak and spikes on its back.
Yeek!
Several disappearances in southern Caloris are already thought to be the work of this creature.
What do we do? Should we send hunters?
The traditional policy on stray beasts is to hope that they return to the forest and stay there. Hunters are no match for such a creature. You would only make it angry and waste more lives. Everyone dies in the end.
Dad!
Okay, so for once, we don't have unique people to visit. So we can actually work on our mood. I would like to be less afraid, so I need to be... Let's do sports.
You take to the court for a few games of tennis. Feel the thrill of competition.
And we're going to switch to wield magic. And boom.
Look how well we're doing.
There is a woman here to see you. She wishes crowdfunding for a project.
Thank you for seeing me, Your Royal Highness. I come to you on behalf of the people. I wish to build a hospital where any citizen afflicted with disease can be brought for treatment.
Centralizing resources could help people who don't have doctors of their own, so it was herbs and battlefield medicine.
We would be happy to invest in your venture.
How much money do we have left? 7,922 gold left. So that seems a lot, I guess. Alright. We're just zooming along.
It goes so much faster when I'm not agonizing over classes.
Unlocked a new outfit. Do you think it's the Lumen Girl outfit?
You are requested. Ooh, this is a good one! I have never passed the skill checks on these.
You are requested to stand in judgment. A woman has been convicted of attempted murder and requests the mercy of the crown. What do we got on Kevin? Is estranged from his mother, lives with the Duchess of Mead, has several younger half-siblings.
Your Highness, this slattern dares to beg pardon when she admits that she tried to poison my sister under her own roof.
Which sister?
Gorisandi, the Duchess of Mead.
His other full sister is the wife of the Duke of Kegal. And his mother is the Duchess of Lilla. Family ties are complicated.
Is she all right?
She is unharmed. We caught the culprit in the kitchens before anyone could eat her foul spew.
Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
It's justice it is. Them devils killed me brother and broke me ma'am's heart. Lied to her, they did, when she went to see why he'd not come back. Said he'd gone for a soldier when he never would. He weren't the only one, neither.
I waited 10 years for my chance to get my own back. That's justice. You see? She's completely unrepentant. Hang her and be done with it.
I love that Kevin has like a popped collar, and he's also kind of one of the jerkier nobles. Although he's a victim and has been victimized, and I'm not trying to laugh at that.
This must be about the last Duke of Mead. He had a lot of servants who were mysteriously injured or killed. But he's dead, and he either killed himself or his family helped him along. So we're going to tell her that justice was already done.
You are wrong. Justice was already done by the gods and by the nobles that you've despised. The one who killed your brother is dead. He was replaced by wiser rulers, like the Duchess you tried to harm. You blamed an innocent woman, one who might have had sympathy for you if you had told her the truth. Not all nobles are the same.
I never thought.
You will have time to think about your actions in the dungeons.
She should be hanged.
She acted for the love of her sibling. Surely you can understand that. No one else needs to die.
There is a couple of ratings that go in the background. One is Elodie's cruelty rating, one is her commoner approval, and one is her nobility approval. Commoner approval affects things like whether there's a commoner uprising, and nobility affects things like whether there's a civil war. In order to get all the steam achievements, which we will eventually do someday, we would need to do things with those approvals to get them up and down. So for instance, if we want to face a commoner uprising, which I think is one of the steam achievements, we will need to make bad decisions that make the commoners hate us. So what we just did by taking that third option, I think we managed to keep the woman alive without losing nobility approval, and I think that upped commoner approval. I'm not sure.
Let's go dancing. You attend a formal ball, which gives you the chance to interact with the nobility in a less stressful environment. And sure enough, there's our magical girl Lumen outfit. But I want my scholar's gown. I love that gown. I would wear that gown. Where are our skills? Okay, so let's do a wield magic and two resist magics. One sense and one resist. How about that? There we go. Very nice.
As you are walking in one day in the gardens, you hear a strange sound and look up to see an owl flying overhead. A single dry leaf flutters in its talons. An owl in daylight and a dead leaf. Someone important will die in the next few months. A young gardener has also paused in his work to watch the bird's flight.
Wait, you've seen that boy before.
You.
Ah, I've never seen his face before. I knew that there was a commoner, but I'd never seen him.
Ah, good day, princess.
You're a thief. You stole my apples.
Who, me?
I saw you sneaking out of the garden.
Sure, you saw me in the garden because I work here. Name's Evrard? A gardener? Name's Evrard.
I don't remember any Evrard working here.
I'm sure a princess doesn't know the name of every servant in this big place.
Actually, I do. Court manners a success. Look at her face. I love that. Actually, I do.
Huh. Not what I would have expected.
Well, you've caught me. I snuck into the palace to steal an apple and look at a pretty girl.
What are you going to do about it?
I'm not going to arrest him.
I guess he has to leave?
Nothing. As long as you leave now.
I didn't expect a princess to have a sense of fun. Maybe we'll meet again sometime. He winks at you and saunters off towards the hedge. Oh, bless his heart. I guess we'll play sports again? Rawr. Okay, how are we on skills? So we could take 2 resists and max it out, I think. There we go. Remember that the Festival of the Good Lady is approaching. There will be public celebrations for the commoners, followed by a grand gala for the nobility. A grand ball. There will be dancing. As queen, you would be expected to lead the procession and take part in the ceremonial planting, possibly give a speech. However, since you are not yet crowned, it is not required, and it may not be safe to expose you to the public.
What do you mean, not safe?
Outside of the castle, you are less well protected. If anyone means you harm, think on it now and decide later. Word has come from the factory for books that you funded. They have assembled enough equipment to begin printing test pamphlets. As their royal sponsor, it is your right to determine the content of the first printing. I don't know why strategy was... I mean, it was his suggestion, but... So you're going to poems praising your mother, army recruitment, pro-Lumen propaganda, or religious doctrine. I'm trying for, like, the best possible ending, so we're going to go with pro-Lumen propaganda. I think the people of Nova don't have enough respect for magic users. I want to print pamphlets about lumens. Being afraid of magic can blind people to more ordinary dangers. Oh, I know what that lore test was for. There's a lore, it's a really high level one, it's a cool story about how there was a well with glowing poisoned water and a lumen took the glow off thinking it was like a curse and drank the water and died because the water was naturally poisonous and a lumen had just illuminated the water as a warning. You know, like, so people thought the water was magic and bad, but it was naturally bad and the magic was to warn them. So that was what that lore check was for. I really like how if you got the knowledge and read the tooltips, then it makes sense why that was a check. I love that. Being afraid of magic can blind people to more ordinary dangers. We should respect magic, but not fear it. Your mother thought something similar. He sighs. As you wish. There is a letter for you as well. It's from Brienne. I went to school with her, but she's a couple years older than me. Her mother is the Duchess of Mead. She's complaining that her mother still won't let her come home for the holidays. She's bored and looking for an adventure. Well, I don't have any to suggest to her. I love that sad little as you wish. It means he doesn't approve of what you've decided. I guess we could bring Willful down, but I like my Willful high. What is Visit Dungeons? You sneak a... What did it do? Willfulness. You sneak a peek at some of the luckless peasants held in the dungeons. Petty thieves and troublemakers now suffering in the dark. They're obviously bad people, but seeing them so miserable feels unfair. There must be a better way. Alrighty. We are going to do wield magic. Lots of it. Look at us learn. Oh my gosh, we're so smart. Today is the procession and planting of the Festival of the Good Lady. Will you be leading the parade? If you have any concerns about your safety, please stay here. The people will recover from disappointment. If we lose you, there is no recovery. So we're going to lead the parade and make a speech. I'm not afraid. I'm going to be the best parade leader ever. My little girl. You prepare your best gown for the occasion.
then walk slowly through the town with your attendants. It would not be appropriate for you to wear a sword, but you do walk with a sturdy golden scepter that's taller than you are. You can tell from the excited murmurs around you that the people are impressed with your queenly appearance. At the end of the route, you help the priestesses turn over the earth for the new tree to be planted. After blessings are read, you hold up your hands and call for silence so you can speak. My affectionate greetings to you all, and my thanks, for it is the people that make this domain great. We are here today to celebrate the gifts of the good lady, the promise of fertility and new birth. Winter always comes, but winter is followed by spring. Each of us faces hardships, but we grow back stronger than ever. Now is the time for new beginnings and for my beginning as your queen. Your words are met with great applause. The procession regroups to return to the castle. Look how good we did, oh my gosh. Okay. We're gonna go ahead and attend court. It's not fun, but it pleases your father and may be important for your future. And then we're gonna do some sense magic and some wheel magic. And I think that will max out all of our magic. Oh, crumbs. We made it in time. We're maxed out on everything. Yes! Are you ready for the grand ball? All the nobles in the domain are here to see you, to see their queen. You finish dressing and descend the stairs to make a grand entrance. All around, the rich and powerful pause in their activities to gaze upon you, the ruler of them all. You let your eyes rest upon each in turn as you have been taught, impressing upon them that you are not a child, but a queen. Your father waits for you at the bottom of the stairs and offers you his arm. The first dance is for us. He guides you gently around the dance floor, never rushing you. It's fun to dance with your father, but the look in his eyes is so sad. After this, you must choose your own partner. There are a number of men who hope to catch your eye. The Duke of Kegel alone has brought 3 eligible sons, all near your age. You look around the room at all your possible partners, which is to say everyone. No one may begin dancing until you do. You can pick whomever you want and you will not be denied. No doubt every noble family with eligible sons has dreams of a royal wedding. Your choice will raise some hopes and dash others. Feuds could be born here. The Duke of Kegel has not yet named any of his sons as official heir, but his second son, Linley, was always kind to you at school. If you wished to show favor to Kegel, Linley would be your choice. The Duchy of Eilat is currently held in regency for its young lord Adair, who is only 12 and a head shorter than you are. Eilat is a rich territory, and at least little Adair wouldn't try to take any liberties. Dancing with Banyan, the Duke of Marie, could be quite awkward if you did not actually wish to marry him. He has been waiting years for a powerful heiress to accept his suit. Not all nobles are created equal. You could choose someone charming and unimportant, like the Earl of Mima, a territory too minor for anyone to consider a threat. However, the major families might eat him alive afterwards. If you wish to distract attention from your marital prospects, you could choose someone clearly ineligible, one of your uncles, or an older family man like the Earl of Ishtar, or even a woman, though that would be mildly scandalous. So, oh my goodness, so many people. We're just gonna say Kayla. I have so many things I want to do. I want to do all the things. I want to see all of them, so I'm just gonna. He bows you with great courtesy, and you begin to dance. Dancing with a real partner feels quite different from dancing with your father. You knew him, knew his steps like a part of you. Now every move is a mystery. Of course, you are an excellent dancer, and relish the chance to show off your hard-earned skills. A ballroom dance isn't nearly as much of a showcase as a stage performance, but you can easily impress the guests with your technique and style. Okay, so that didn't have anything for... That was Linley. This is a dare. Oh, look, y'all said he had a face. Look at his cute little face. Hi, Elodie. Oh,
He looks absolutely terrified at the prospect of having to dance with a girl, but the little lord is too well-bred to refuse you. Still, you'll have to be careful not to step on him. Oh, look at his sweet face. Banyan, he looks all too satisfied as he takes up position before you.
Is that all? No talking? He's about to be a jerk to us, I know.
This is the Mima guy. He smiles brightly at your approach and you begin to dance. Oh, bless his heart. They did say he was charming. Armand is your father's brother. At a distance, Armand looks a great deal like your father. However, your father would never look so uneasy at being asked to dance with you. Oh, why are you uneasy, Armand? And Erwin is the older. I think we're going to dance with him because I like him very much. Examine the women. As a queen, few would dare comment about your choice of companions. But until you have provided an heir to the throne, there is great pressure on you to make an appropriate match. That doesn't mean you have to give in. It might be entertaining to see the reaction of Juliana, Duchess of Rasul, if you asked her to dance with you. Would she be flustered for once? After you pressured Bryn, the Duchess of Hellas, into marrying an Ixonite, it might be something of a peace offering to dance with her now. You know that she prefers women, and she knows that you know. Dancing with her might set up expectations. The most important woman present after yourself is Aris, Duchess of Lilla. She is married, elderly, a mother and grandmother many times over, but might be flattered by the acknowledgement of her status. Or if you truly wanted to set the court on its ear, you could demand your first dance with a mere servant, a maid like Alice. The assembled nobles would be outraged. We're going to have multiple Kayla saves. Let's try Juliana. You were hoping such an outrageous act would cause her to lose some of her composure, but she remains unruffled. At least the chorus of shocked whispers around you as you take your place on the floor is gratifying. You feel deliciously wicked at the expression of shock on Bryn's face, but it soon fades into something more ambiguous. Her hand in yours is warm, and too late you wonder if you're playing with fire. I love Bryn so much. Don't tell anybody. Aris, you approach the grand old lady, uncomfortably aware that in some eyes she may look more like a queen than you do. The room holds its breath as you stand before her, waiting for her reaction. Then with dignity, she extends her hand to you. And Alice. Have the maid Alice brought here. I wish to dance with her. All sound in the room stops, save for little Adair's nervous laughter. Still, you have given a royal command, and thus someone goes to find the maid. A few minutes later, Alice is pushed out into the glittering throng by a pair of manservants. Oh my gosh. No, I could never do that to her. Okay, so we have to decide between the Earl of Ishtar and Bryn because we're going to go with Ishtar. I like the older guy. He's nice. After all, he's old enough to be your grandfather, and his wife is right there with him. He seems startled by your approach at first, then thoughtful, and accepts your hand with a kindly smile. You guys are gonna think I'm such a sap, but I really like that for some reason. Like, he's surprised because he thought you would go for literally anybody else in the room. You're this young, pretty princess. Of course, you're gonna dance with a young, pretty prince. And then he realizes what you've realized, which is that you don't want to commit to anything yet. And then he's kind about it, and he helps you and dances with you, and it just, it's so sweet to me. And then we're a good dancer, 'cause we are. Between dances, there is time for guests to mingle, chat, and sample tiny bites of exquisite food. You interact comfortably with your peers, leaving a wise word in every ear. You notice that Fabian, the elderly Earl of Titian, is not looking entirely well. Could this have something to do with the omen the owl brought to you of death and disruption?
Fabian is the father of and regent for Adair, the young lord of Illath. The boy is only 12 years. He's only 12 years too young to assume his full title. Almost all of Adair's near-blood relatives have died in the past 30 years. His mother, Kaylee, died in childbirth. Her mother and sisters are suspected to have been victims of agents from Sedna. If Fabian dies before Adair is of age, there will be a succession crisis in Illath. Public speaking, I remember if your flattery in public speaking is too low, you say something like, "Are you okay? I'm afraid you'll die soon." Lord Fabian, might I have a word with you? I am concerned about the future of your son, Adair. My mother's death has made it clear to me that we are all mortal, and solid plans need to be in place. You worry for a moment about how the old man will take such a subject, but he only sighs and nods. So he's father of four adult children with his first wife. His second wife, Kaylee, died giving birth to her son, Adair. Some of my family would claim I have already lived forever and could continue to do so. But the mornings do grow colder. I hope to see Adair become a man, but I know it may not happen. I know she's no blood of his, but I say, leave the boy with Aris and her brood in Lilla. Her youngest three are near enough to Adair's siblings, Adele especially. She dotes on him. My other children are too old. Adair's never known them. And his grandfather. Well, he and I will never settle who should have known better. And it's too late now. Still, I would never trust him with Kaylee's son. He pats your hand. Good little girl. For thinking of me. What will come will come.
Adair comes running up to his father. Dad, I got punch on my shoes.
You leave them to deal with that problem. You guys, I'm sorry. I don't mean to cry in my microphone. I'm sorry.
During a lull in the music, Banyan, the Duke of Marie, taps an elegant fingernail against a wine glass, letting the clear note ring out through the room.
If I might have your attention, I believe we should offer our compliments to our lovely hostess. Not only does she protect our borders, but she has begun to address the long-standing problem of a shortage of heirs. My sister is proud to do her duty, as of course are others, such as myself and our lovely new queen. You can almost hear the chorus of eyebrows being raised. He's trying to suggest that he and I have some sort of romantic arrangement. If I don't deflect that, everyone will be sure it's true. May I have this dance, fair lady? So, we can accept or refuse, and I'm gonna accept just, and then I'm probably gonna reject him because I don't wanna get tied down to him.
Certainly.
He pulls you close, his hand possessive on your waist as the orchestra swings back into motion. His head above yours angles down to murmur words that you hope no one else can hear.
You realize you have just admitted to all your guests that you and I are having an affair.
I know. I'm the queen. I can have whatever favorites I like. Then drop them when they bore me.
And that will hurt your reputation more than it does mine.
Ruthless, aren't you? Without allies, even a queen can reach too far, and you do need a husband. I only ask you to consider it. We could do much together. So I'm going to refuse him because I don't want to get locked into an engagement.
You are pushing your luck, Banyan.
Your use of his untitled name does not intimidate him. Am I? Surely, as queen, you would act in accordance with your responsibilities, just as you expect of your court.
Yes, I will marry. But I will marry the person who is best suited for me and my domain. So if you want to win my hand, you'd better set about proving your worth. The Duke of Marie smiles wryly and inclines his head to you, acknowledging you the victor of this little verbal sparring match. As the gala continues, you take the opportunity to observe nobles that you rarely see. There's Gwynelle, for instance, the young lady of Sudbury, only months older than you and due to finally inherit control of her duchy soon. Or Adele, the youngest daughter of Duchess of Lilla and a fierce sportswoman. She was a few years ahead of you at school and the absolute terror of the ball fields. No Briony, she said her parents were leaving her stuck at school this season. Her parents are here dancing together, the Duke consort clutching his Duchess possessively tight. Strange that there's no sign of your cousins, though. Shouldn't they be here? Your aunt and uncle are here, of course. It would be scandalous if they hadn't come, Merva being so close by. Oh, okay, now what do we do? If we talk to her... I don't want to kill her. That makes Charlotte sad. But if you don't kill her, then she makes you infertile or continues trying to assa- Oh, we'll talk to her and leave her alive. I don't want to keep her as a minister, though. Aunt Lucille, may I speak with you privately? Of course, dear. I can sense your powers. You're a lumen. I am too. Can't you sense that? No. No, I can't. I do have a lumen crystal. I found it years ago, but I don't know anything about magic. I can make the crystal appear and disappear, and I can block out sound. That's all. I don't think that's true at all. There are traces of old magic around her, too faint to make sense of, but strong. Your Highness, please don't tell anyone. So, I don't like this. If I accuse her, she tries to kill me and I kill her and then Charlotte's at. If I offer her a court position, then all the assassination attempts coincidentally go down to zero. But in the epilogue, there's a chance she might try to make you infertile to keep you from having kids. We'll promise not to tell and hope that maybe my spy uncovers something. I understand. Don't worry. I promise I will protect your secret. Thank you, dear. What do we got there? Nothing. Secret lumen. Okay, whew. That was a long one. We did really good, though. Didn't we do good? Okay, so we can either do a lonely... I don't want to keep pressured up. Wow, attending ball makes you depressed. That sucks. Now I'll visit the castle. Or treasury. Okay. Look at all of our skills maxed out. I'm so proud of us. We worked hard for that. Actually, I'm joking, but we did work hard for... I did work hard for that because I had to type in every single skill twice. It wasn't fun. You wander downstairs to visit your father and talk about the latest events in the domain. There's Siren. Age 25, a single. You are too kind, Jocelyn. Countess Siren, not a member of your circles. She has two minor titles, no husband, and your father's arm in her grasp. You take a deep breath. So, I always feel really conflicted about Siren because... I don't want my father to feel like he can't marry, but apparently he doesn't want to marry her. So he can greet her politely, trip her as she passes, insult her with false flattery, shame her with silent scorn. I don't remember... What is this false flattery? Good afternoon, Countess. What a lovely brooch you're wearing. It reminds me a bit of one my mother used to wear.
I suppose you have an eye for valuable prizes, don't you? Ready to leap in and snatch them the instant they become available to keep them out of anyone else's hands. I should go. Bye! Let's do the scorn. You meet her eyes and imagine your mother's disapproving presence behind you. Her color pales, and she releases her grip on your father's arm, mumbling an apology before hurrying out of the room. You have defeated her. This is the path you have set us on.
What do you mean?
Your acts have made everyone think about preparations for the future. Caloris needs an heir. My brother, your uncle Armand, is looking for a wife as well. One of us must produce more children. Nothing can ever replace your mother, but we all have to do things we don't want to do. You should be careful how you deal with people like Siren. You need the goodwill of your nobles as well as your commoners. As queens, you must be aware of everything around you.
Okay. So, why did I put 19? It's not 19, it's 18. I'm not worried about noble plots because I'm keeping everybody happy. I'm not worried about commoner uprising. Foreign threats would be nice because we know that's coming, but I'm actually gonna...
I don't know if Assassins does anything more than help with the bandits on the way to the party. Let's do foreign threats.
I need to know if any foreign powers are moving against me.
We'll hire the spy for Lucille and hope for the best.
It is the time of year to decide any necessary adjustments to the royal budget. The majority of the money we receive is spoken for. Based on the records and notes of current expenditures, if you maintain the current rate of tax, you will still have 7,921 gold lassi and 59 silver till lassi available for special projects. You can't imagine any reason you would need to spend more. You could afford to lower taxes. 4,000 lassi should be enough to cover any military surprises. Any little trade disruption shouldn't need more than a few hundred lassi to sort out.
I guess we'll lower them? I think we have enough money. Let's lower the taxes a little.
What shall we train in this week?
I cannot tell you what a burden it is off my shoulders to not constantly be fighting the training demons.
You requested to stand in judgment.
Demons made me do it. We've seen this one.
This man is a lumen. Where did he get a crystal?
It was a demon's magic that killed your wife, not your own?
So you know what I am.
Gold chains slash at you like whips. With so much warning, it is easy for you to resist. His attack bounces harmlessly off your shields. Before your eyes, the renegade lumen is choked to death by his own powers. I guess I'll have to take that for safekeeping. Alright, let's go to the services.
My lady, there is a letter for you. Who sent this? It isn't signed.
It appears to be a poem, describing you in a manner that is entirely inappropriate for a queen. With a squid? So, I didn't know this, and I think it's funny, and I'm probably not going to bother trying to get it. But, when Talarist, assuming you accept Talarist's necklace, he will come to visit. He will suggest an engagement. You can let him down, but you can do it ungently if you don't have enough court manners. And you can say, I'm not marrying you, I'm too young. Then later, at the end of the game, if you try to marry him and if he finds this paper, apparently he'll turn you down saying that you have sex with squids or something. And you end up marrying his younger brother and he gets completely shut out of Nova politics entirely. Which I find hilarious, and I don't know if we're actually going to do that, but That's terrible. Who writes this garbage? Let's go with hilarious. That's actually pretty funny. Okay, so we never have... Let's climb out and grab it. You take a moment to look at where you'll have to climb in order to reach your target. Easy peasy. You've been over harder walls than that. Carefully keeping 3 points in contact with strong support, you clamber up and grab the offending document, returning safely to your room. It's nice to know you can rely on your skills at times like these. Ooh, there's a Juliana one.
Psst, I need to talk to you. That priestess, Celine, she's a lumen.
What do you mean you know? If you knew that, why didn't you tell me? Your job is managing the domain. Some of us have other duties. Our mission has been passed down for centuries, little princess. Where did she get a crystal? All the lumens in the domain were supposed to have been wiped out 200 years ago, except for your ancestor. Your duty is to me and to Nova. Renegade lumens pose a threat to the entire domain. If there is a secret cabal of magic users, I need to know about it. There is no cabal. Celine and yourself and I are the only lumens I know. 200 years ago, my ancestor accepted public disgrace so that one trained lumen would survive when all others perished. We have borne the shame ever since to preserve the training and lore for the future of Nova. Do not tell me of my duty, princess. I am sworn not to my queens, but to Nova. Queens die. The magic must not.
Oh, we didn't get the conversation about... crystals not being destroyable.
I regret to inform you that Fabian, the Earl of Titan, and Duke Regent of Elath has passed away.
I expected that was coming.
With the control of Elath in doubt, it falls to the crown to make decisions. Young Lord Adair will not reach his 15th birthday for over 2 years. He requires a regent. His stepmother, Arise, the Duchess of Lilla, has petitioned the boy be left in her care. This would, however, leave her in personal control of 2 neighboring duchesses, which is generally forbidden. Not to mention that she's closely related to the Duchess of Mead and the Duke of Kegel. She could control almost the entire eastern half of Nova. People already call her Nova's other queen. Duchess Arise almost certainly killed her second husband after she divorced him. Her son, the Earl of Io, apparently hates and fears her. And the last Duke of Mead died in mysterious circumstances while she was around, which meant that the title of Mead passed to Arise's daughter, but without proof she couldn't be punished. The boy does have a living grandfather, the Earl of Ishtar.
He's the one we danced with.
Or you might appoint an unrelated noble to act in his stead. The Earl of Ishtar has suggested another possibility. You and Adair are both young, not too far apart in age. He requests that we accept the boy as your future husband and keep him here at the castle. I talked to the late regent at the gala about what he wanted for his son's future. He said Adair should either stay with his stepmother or his stepsister Adele. Adele would be a less politically dangerous choice. He also said definitely not to give Adair to his grandfather. So, I'm not going to marry him in this one for purely selfish reasons that I know that he's a steam achievement that I haven't gained yet for kissing your fiance, because he gives you a little kiss. And I don't want to get the steam achievement while I'm debugging, because I feel like that would be unfair to you guys. Here's how to get the steam achievement. Cheat! You know, so we're going to leave him with her, or make his stepsister Adele regent.
Let him stay with his family. But instead of Arise, give the regency to Adair's stepsister Adele. They've grown up together and she's old enough for the responsibility. She doesn't have a title of her own, and is more likely to be loyal to Elath's interests.
A clever compromise.
Thank you!
If you attack an enemy lumen and they win, is it possible to combine their crystal with mine to make it stronger? Each lumen can hold only 1 crystal. The only way to combine their magic is if a living wielder chooses to join their power to another. So I should destroy other crystals to stop anyone using them against me. That is the traditional policy, but it is a lie. Lumen crystals cannot be destroyed. Rulers claim otherwise to discourage thieves from seeking dangerous treasures. Guard it, or hide it, or give it into other hands to wield. It will be attuned to a personality as foolish or violent or scheming as the lumen you defeated, though. so anyone taking the crystal would probably become a new enemy. That's useless.
So... Oh, there it is. Wait, in the past, all the dukes and duchesses of Nova were lumens. That means all those crystals must be out there somewhere.
Yes, we got the thingy. Oh, we're cheerful. That's fine. We're very cheerful, my goodness.
There is a woman here to see you. She is a musician and wishes crown patronage.
Your Royal Highness, if you accept me as a member of your court, I will immortalize you in word and song. I have dabbled in musical styles from many countries, and I can entertain your guests and lighten your evenings.
I wonder if she also writes naughty poetry.
The Queen of Shanji was taken in by a musician who turned out to be after her crown. Not only that, but a lumen in disguise, and now ruling her domain. I don't sense any magic about this one, though. Musicians are often used as secret agents and messengers. They can be useful and dangerous. It's okay, but nothing special. That might mean she has other talents.
You are familiar with the traditions of many locations, yes? Can you perform accents?
That I can. What about juggling?
I can keep a set of dangers in the air.
Interesting. I look forward to all you have to tell me. We'll talk privately to see how much she knows, but I think she might be useful.
Oh, look! We can talk to Sabine! I'm so happy.
You guys, I love... Everybody always says, oh, cheating ruins your enjoyment of the game or whatever, but I'm having a blast. Don't ever listen to people.
Your Highness, thank you again for the opportunity.
Yes. Now, what have you heard on your travels? What are the people saying about me?
I haven't yet had the chance to play at many noble courts, although I intend to.
Your kindness has already won the hearts of the common folk of Nova. They follow you wherever you lead. Of course, with me at your side, your popularity can only increase. Never underestimate the power of music.
Yes, I am happy. I am as happy as Elodie is happy.
You receive a letter from young Lord Adair. It's a bit messy and hard to read, but he seems to be thanking you for letting him stay with the family he knows.
Baby.
Okay, so... depression, lonely, afraid. These things are okay. We'll visit tomb. Pay respects to your mother's tomb. Now we're willful again. Willful is really the best mood, I think. Cheerful's pretty good, but... nothing beats willful.
Your agents report a buildup in military strength, particularly warships in Sanjia, the major power across the ocean to the west. They may be intending to go on the attack. The Queen of Sanjia has been conquering her smaller neighbors recently. Sanjia lies a great distance from Nova. You have few diplomatic ties and no known conflicts. There's no reason to assume you would be their target. Still, if they send a fleet across the ocean, Nova might be in danger. At the very least, shipping would be disrupted. And that would be a disaster to the Nova economy. We have to keep the shipping lanes clear. It takes time to assemble worthy vessels, and you have advance warning. You could make your own preparations to defend your coast. The downside is, they won't come cheap.
So we're gonna build warships. That's week 25, what am I doing?
You send order for the assembly of new ships and the strengthening of weaponry and cladding on the existing fleet. If trouble comes, you'll be ready for it.
Except, oh gosh, which ending should I be going for? Should I be going for the singing ending? Or should I be going for the one where we sink them all at sea? The singing ending is better because you're an angel. But sinking them all at sea is... very emotionally satisfying. And sinking them all at sea is also satisfying because you know that they're not going to, like, pillage their way and burn their way to the castle. Which is a thing I don't like. She's gonna stab somebody with that pen.
What a beautiful day! It's nice to stop and breathe sometimes.
That's usually the week where Adair gets assassinated if you sent him to live with his grandfather.
My lady, there are letters for you. Gwynell's birthday party. Gwynell is about to turn 15. She'll be Duchess of Sudbury for real now. The other letter must be my invitation to her birthday celebration. This will be a big event, but it's a long way to travel, and a lot of things can happen on the road.
You remember dreaming about a road through a dark forest, surrounded by monsters like the Keithong your father told you about. Of course, the old forest is nowhere near Sudbury.
So we'll go. It'll be good to see my friends, and I'm going because I know we can survive it.
We are that awesome. I think we can survive it. I'm pretty sure.
On the journey to Sudbury, your castle carriage is attacked by bandits sent by Lucille, by the way. You hear the distinctive sound of incoming arrows just in time to push yourself away from the window and avoid being shot. From the screams outside, not all of your guards have been as lucky. The attackers scatter as soon as your forces show signs of resistance, vanishing into the woods. The rest of your trip passes without incident, but you can't help jumping at shadows.
Gwynell's party is lovely. Not nearly as glamorous as your own upcoming birthday will be, of course, but it's still a major event on the noble social calendar. Uncle Lauren and your younger cousins are here. Charlotte and her mother are not. Apparently Charlotte was ill. There are refreshments and dancers and musicians and polite conversation.
So this is Leek, the Countess of Dis. Divorced her first husband as soon as she gave birth to his heir Gwynell, then married Bennett. So I'm understanding that she's not really respected by the nobility because she married high, she married a noble, she gave birth to his heir, and then immediately divorced him and has been regent to the girl ever since. So she's kind of an upstart, is what I've read. And Anciot is the little kid.
Will not be shoved aside. Mother, it's my own domain now. I need space for myself. You have your own lands to manage.
Just because you're of age doesn't mean you know everything, young lady. You need my advice.
This is my home. It has never been yours.
Before you can back away, their gazes fall on you. They wait expectantly for you as near queen to settle the dispute.
Feelings could be easily hurt on either side here. It's important that everyone involved save face. I'm sure you have a great deal of wisdom to impart, but isn't that what you've already done? You have to trust in the strength of your own teachings. Trust in the strength and intelligence of your daughter.
Neither of them looks entirely happy, but neither looks angry with you either.
Brienne! There she is.
Hello, Elodie. It's so wonderful you're going to be queen now. I mean, I am sorry about your mother. But think of the opportunities you're going to have. You're so lucky.
That's an odd way of putting it.
Anyway, I was wondering, now that you're almost queen and everything, have they told you all the secrets?
What secrets?
Like how to get into the old palace. I've heard it's packed full of treasure.
You mean the old capital by Caffrey Lake? The abandoned one?
Exactly. They had to leave in a hurry, so they left all kinds of treasure behind. And nobody ever goes there, because the forest is supposed to be haunted. So the treasure's probably still there.
The forest isn't just haunted. It's full of monsters like the Keithong.
But what if she's right, and it is full of ancient treasure? So, if you try to talk her out of it now, I think it doesn't take.
Let me try. Tattle to her parents.
The forest is...
Wait, okay, I'm gonna try all these. Okay, so tattle to her parents.
You nod and smile politely. Then as soon as Brienne isn't looking, you report on her scheme to her mother, the Duchess of Mead. Her mother is very grateful for the warning. Hopefully Brienne will be safe now.
So talking to her out of it is...
That forest is dangerous, Brienne. Not because of ghosts, because of monsters.
Do you know what happens when a monster from the forest gets loose and kills someone? Nothing. Nobody does anything because the monsters are too powerful to fight. So we just let them eat whoever they want and hope they don't take too many. If you go there, you'll die, and everyone will say it was your own fault.
You're scaring me. That's the point.
Okay, okay. Maybe I should think a little more about this plan. You're no fun. But we're gonna offer to help because I do want our situation to get better. I don't know any secrets about getting into the old palace yet. But if you come back to the castle with me, we can check the archives.
Great, I knew you'd help.
I'm supposed to go back to school, but I was already planning to sneak off. I'll ditch my escort, sneak ahead, and meet you at the castle. This could be fun. At the end, you all share a pleasant meal and prepare to return to your various lands. Ugh! I think there's a way to talk to Aris, the Duchess of Lilithair, but I never have been able to. Maybe you have to give a dare to her for that to work. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you can't talk to her, but I thought you could. I found a bunch of maps of the area around Cathry Lake. Great! I also found reports on all sorts of really nasty monsters down there. The palace was abandoned hundreds of years ago. The reports never stopped. I can't find anyone who's gone into the old forest and come back. But look, I know it's dangerous. I'm not stupid. But you and I are educated noblewomen, not peasants. I'm good with a sword and a bow. And you, don't you have magic powers now that you're queen? Well, yes. So come with me. It'll be an awesome adventure. Our parents are going to be so impressed. Is that what this is really about? Briony's parents? Briony, what is going on with you and your family? Nothing. Really nothing. Ever since Uncle Kevin moved in, my parents don't want anything to do with me. I'm an adult now, you know. And they still say I have to be at school all the time. I'm the heir. I should be spending time in Mead. I don't know when my uncle moved in. A few years ago, after Gran's divorce. The Duchess of Lilla divorced her second husband, Giles, and he died right afterwards. She probably had him killed. Most people think that was no great loss, because there were all sorts of horrible rumors about Jail. But the Earl of Eo, Brienne's uncle Kevin, was quite upset about it. I guess he liked his stepfather? That must have been a stressful time for your family. Yeah, I'm sure, but so what? That was years ago. They've had plenty of time to get over it. I just want them to pay attention to me. If you find lost treasures of Nova, they have to notice.
You've already run away from school. If they don't notice that, they won't notice anything.
You mean it's hopeless? No, I mean all you need to do is stay here and wait. Getting into trouble won't make a difference. Oh, I guess maybe you're right. Thanks, Elodie. You're smarter than I remembered. Ugh!
Because I don't want to be willful. I don't want to be pressured. I don't want to lose my wonderful willfulness.
The Duchess of Mead is here to see you, my lady. Elodie, where is my daughter?
So wow, we've got her elder half-brother Hyacinth was Duke of Mead before her, but Hyacinth died without heirs. Before his death, Hyacinth was scandalously involved with Pallas, the old Duke of Ursul, Ignatius's father. Hyacinth's death was under mysterious circumstances and may have been suicide or murder. Her brother Kevin lives with her.
Which daughter? You know very well, I have only one.
Really, mother? Because sometimes I think you don't have one at all.
Briony, thank goodness you're all right.
Oh, now you care? You certainly didn't want to see me before. You haven't let me come home in ages.
Briony, darling, there are things you don't understand.
I don't understand because you never tell me anything.
The Duchess sighs and embraces her daughter. Very well, if that's what it will take, come home with me and I will explain everything.
Which I still think would be just the most awkward conversation in the whole world. Because the thing she's explaining is that she and her brother are having sex, like she and Kevin, the red-haired, popped-collar guy. All over the place.
As you are walking through the great hall, a freak gust of wind suddenly blows out all the candles in the room. An omen of war and danger. It must be Shandia. They're going to attack.
You receive a letter from Briony hinting at some of the complicated family drama that has been going on. Her father keeps alternating between wanting a divorce and being afraid of losing his home.
And if you keep Juliana imprisoned and elevate her father and elevate Brienne's father to Juliana's duchy as duke and promote him over her, then he does get a divorce, and there's a steam achievement for that. There's an extra section at the end of the letter written in code. Her uncle and her stepfather? Her uncle and his stepfather? That was a Jael guy. Her uncle and her mother? No wonder she was trying to hide it. Okay, I have to pause and go get something to drink for just a second, because I'm starting to stumble over my words. I need some water. So, we will be back in just a moment. And we're back. I have lemonade. Alright, we were looking at mood things. I kind of want my pressure to go down. And it's like everything gives you pressured. Play with toys. All right. Things have been so unsettled lately. Everyone's on edge. We need something cheerful. You could hold a tournament. Good idea! So we're gonna say employment. The winners will have the option of taking up royal appointments. It's a recruitment drive! As you move through the hall, your eye falls upon a vase of flowers. Pretty, but apparently not getting enough water. The leaves on one blossom have shriveled. A leaf killed by a secret weakness, a hidden threat. You continue up the stairs to your room, where a maid is waiting for you. My lady, a gift has arrived from Kegel. From the Duke? No, my lady, a merchant house, I believe. It was sent with a shipment down the Kavala River. You tear open the brightly colored paper to find chocolates! Chocolate producers in Kegel usually ship goods down the Napo River through Ursul, not straight to the capital. This merchant house probably specializes in something else and only traded for the chocolate. There is a little card with the box, with our compliments, the House of Krellet. That's oddly high-handed for some tiny trader I've never heard of. With our compliments. Court manners. That's oddly high-handed for some tiny trader I'd never heard of. All of a sudden, your puppy, who is usually so well-behaved, growls at the box of chocolates and lunges at it. Bad dog, chocolate isn't good for you. Silly thing, making such a fuss. There's something suspicious about this. Oops, we're on 32. It's funny because you can still eat it even after all those correct tests. Tests for poison. Sense magic. The gift doesn't appear to be enchanted, at least. You know enough about poisons to conduct some simple experiments. Sadly, your suspicions prove correct. Someone has tried to kill you. You send for the guards and begin asking a lot of pointed questions about these chocolates and how they got to your room without a food taster. I get it, though. A box of chocolates, you don't want to be the one to, like, mess it up and eat one and mess up the pretty... Really, it was on Elodie to not test one or send one to a food taster herself. We won't say that. Okay. And you remember, if you save them for later, one of your maids eats one and dies, and it's tragic and sad. Not Alice, just a maid.
This is the week of the general tournament. Nobles and commoners alike have turned out to compete against each other. The people will be pleased if you participate in their games. However, it would expose you to danger. So, this is interesting to me because... Excuse me. This is interesting to me because with our max out skills, and I want to see them all, but as I recall, you're kind of decent and good at everything whenever you have the relevant skill maxed out, except music, which you win, which is a really neat piece of foreshadowing that Elodie, even at 14, has really remarkable talent, which she can then use to charm the Shanjian king with her voice. And I also saw somebody else online point out that Elodie is really close to Melody, which I thought was cool too. So, I've never been good at falconry. Only nobles take part in the falconry competition, of course. The only commoners who fly such birds do so under nobles' aegis. You are far too new to the sport to be in contention for a prize, but it is a pleasant learning experience, and your fellow competitors are pleased by your interest and enthusiasm. Archery. You make your way to the archery field. Round after round, your arrows fly smoothly towards their target. You don't win in the end, but you were ranked within the top 10, which is highly respectable. Here, the devotees of the blade can challenge each other to duels, fought only for points, not blood and honor. You win your first match to uproarious applause, but are soon overpowered by more experienced competitors. Still, you did very well for your first tournament. Jousting. You make your way to the lists, where you are assigned a horse and a carefully padded lance. To your surprise and the thunderous applause of the crowd, you manage to defeat your first challenger. After that, you were defeated by an older, larger opponent, but there's no shame in that. You choose to lead the parade mounted on a brilliant white horse. You do, of course, know how to ride, and it is not difficult to follow a well-marked procession. Music. You take your place in line for the bardic contest. When your turn comes, you take your seat at a beautiful wooden harp and let notes fall like rain. Your voice weaves a spell of love and loss over the crowd. After such a performance, the judges cannot help but name you the champion. All the winners are announced and displayed to great cheers. As near queen, you place flower garlands around their necks. After the tournament, you receive a report on the poisoned chocolates. The merchant house named on the card is fictitious. No such trader is registered in Kigal. However, the chocolates themselves arrived in a shipment from a trusted supplier, one whose goods are only subject to the occasional sampling checks instead of more thorough scrutiny. It's hard to imagine a supplier willing to risk losing the royal warrant by taking part in a clumsy assassination attempt. The reputation boost of being known to do business with the palace is quite valuable. Regardless, someone in palace security should have been paying more attention. Sorry. I don't mean to be coughing in your ear. Let's say wait for more information. I need to find my real enemy. So now we're going to go talk to Sabine. Your Highness, I never thought I'd say this to someone like you, but I heard you sing at the tournament and you're better than I am. Oh! Sabine! Bless her heart. I didn't hire you for your musical talents. Yes, I know. But I am still a musician, and I'd like to improve my craft. Oh, might we practice together sometime?
Oh. Hello. Hi. Hello.
So accept says I'd like that. Decline is, I'm sorry, I don't have time for music. Perhaps we can teach each other, say, in my room? I may be in your service, Highness, but there are some things not for sale. Oops. Oh, I meant it sincerely. That makes me a little sad. I got all excited. Okay. I'd like that. I didn't mean because she... Do you think we should... Maybe we should have asked anyway? I mean, maybe there's an epilogue ending. Doesn't hurt to ask, right? Oops. I mean, as long as we don't pressure her after, that's fine, right? I don't know.
My lady, your father wishes to speak with you. He says it's urgent. I'll be there in a minute. There's someone I have to talk to first. You wait for the maid to leave, then hurry off to rendezvous with your agent. Your Highness, I had a quiet chat with the workers.
No, I feel bad. Because what if she doesn't want to sing with us because we propositioned her, so we'll just say accept.
I don't want her to not get to sing. That's what would have made her happy.
I don't want to make Sabine unhappy.
Okay. Your Highness, I had a quiet chat with the workers on the cargo ship which carried the poisoned chocolates. Seems someone was bribed to take that package on board, not in Kegel, but further down the river in Merva. I had a look at the card that came with it and checked it against your correspondence. For a moment, you are mildly annoyed that she somehow managed to get into your personal mail and read it without asking you. But then that is the sort of thing you'd hired her for. And the handwriting does bear a certain similarity to a prominent noble. You won't like this. What is it? Your Aunt Lucille, the Countess of Nix. What? I can't be certain, and even if she wrote the card, it doesn't mean she's behind the poison. But I'd be careful. If something happens to you, who benefits? Who inherits? My Uncle Laurent, her husband. If you'd like, I could travel to the ducal seat in Merva, see if I can find out more. Yes, fine, go.
Hold on. Maybe this is all a clever trick. Or a misunderstanding. And Dad wants to talk to me, which is probably more bad news.
You find your father standing over a map of the coastline, his face grave.
Ships have been sighted on approach from Shangia. Not trade ships. This is a war fleet. I had been expecting something like that. Within a week they will be in Novan waters. Within two they could reach the capital. Then we will fight to defend ourselves.
You can try to use the treasury funds to hire additional soldiers, but it may be difficult on short notice. You will need to draw up a naval strategy for our ships to carry out. You could choose to act as admiral and lead the fleet in person, but the danger to you would be very great. Unless you think your personal skills will make the difference, I strongly advise against it.
Oh, we have a hard one here.
If we stay in the capital, then we'll lose our navy. The damage to our economy will be bad. We'll lose a lot of our army, and the people will be, like, pillaged and killed. But we could convince Dagami to stop bothering us forever. If we go to sea, we could sink their ships. We won't lose our ships. We won't lose our navy and soldiers, and we won't have the path to our palace pillaged and burned. But in the epilogue, Shangia is still a threat. Let's direct the fleet. I don't want our
our country pillaged and burned. The risk is mine to take. You have your mother's heart. There is one more thing I hesitate to ask, but an invasion. This is the sort of disaster for which Illumin's power may be worth the cost. If the fleet could be destroyed before they reach our waters, many lives would be saved. I don't know any magic that could sink a whole fleet. I'll have to talk with my mentor. A fleet from Shandia is attacking us. Is it possible to sink them all with magic? It is easy enough to attack one soldier, one ship, as a demonstration, but to obliterate an entire fleet, you would need an immense amount of power spread over a large area, more than any one Lumen could control. If you tried to raise that much power yourself, you would die. Not could, would. The most dangerous power of Imperial Nova was that of Lumens acting in concert. If the need is great and the will is true, one Lumen may choose to give command of her power to another. Three, perhaps four people working together might have the strength to destroy a fleet. You, me, Celine, will that be enough? It might. Are you willing to take the risk? Such power has its price. We're not going to. That raises a kraken. No, I think I'd rather rely on the soldiers to protect me. That wasn't why we didn't do it, but it's fine. You were impressed by the discipline of Novan troops, but the responsibility for their lives weigh heavily on your shoulders. There are approximately 10 battalions, 2 companies, and 1 platoon under your direct command. Your newest ships of the line are undergoing final checkout. Here we go. Let's brush up on strategy and naval strategy.
Oh look, there's nothing more we have to learn about it.
Danger on the high seas. Ships close in on each other, angling into range. You clamber up the rigging to take a position in the crow's nest where you can watch the enemy's movements with a spyglass and shout out any necessary changes in plan. The Shandians outnumber you slightly, but it could all come down to strategy. Your skill in long-range magic makes you as effective as a cannon and more maneuverable, but there are far too many ships for you to take out each one individually. Still, your position in the crow's nest allows you to target ships at a distance too great for them to respond effectively. The eventual outcome is a hard-fought victory! You have repelled the invasion fleet, driving the survivors back across the sea. You and your sailors are heroes, and Nova is safe once more! We did it. We did that thing. The thing is what we did. We did it. You were impressed by the discipline. It didn't count how many we had, you'll notice. But that's okay. We're okay. We are cheerful. I guess I could save the game. What is this, week 35? It's week 36. We have obtained a number of Shanji prisoners who survived the naval battle. A few are from wealthy families and can be ransomed, but most are common sailors and soldiers. What do you intend to do with them? Shanji is a rich and powerful domain. They may be willing to pay ransom even for common citizens, but they did attack us, and giving them their soldiers back makes them stronger. So we can execute them all. Ransom the rich and execute the poor. Ransom the rich and conscript the poor, or ransom them all. I'm gonna ransom them all because A, I feel like it makes us wealthier. B, it's kind of a big, like, it's just a nice thing to do. And C, it's kind of a big screw you to Sanji, like, here are your soldiers back. Good luck next time. Shanji can afford to pay for their sailors as well as their captains. Ask for ransom for all of them. Those with fewer skills may be worth less, but they're not worthless. Aww. Very well. That was sweet.
How's our treasury doing? You have 999 gold, Lassie. That is not very much. That's what happens when you lower taxes and throw a tournament and win a war and build ships.
Now that the issue of prisoners has been dealt with, an enormous festival is held all over Lampsea Island to celebrate your victory over Shandia. People are hanging your portrait outside their homes and decorating it with flowers like a shrine. Everyone loves you. Almost everyone. I have a great deal of news to report. Everything we suspected was true, and worse. Were you aware that your Aunt Lucille is a Lumen? Yes. That might have been helpful for me to know earlier. I promised to keep her secret. Because she was so afraid of her secret coming out that she would kill to protect it? Is that what happened? Not exactly. I found her journals. They were in code, of course, but no match for my talents. Your aunt intends to take over Nova and rule as an unstoppable mother-daughter Lumen team. Charlotte is a Lumen? No, your aunt intends to give her your power and your crown. Where are the journals? I want to see them. If I had taken them, she would know her secret was exposed. Then there's no proof? Proof is a thing that rarely exists, Your Highness. There is always doubt. If this is true, she has to be stopped at once, whatever the cost. If it's not true, I would be attacking my own best support, my family.
So we know Sabine isn't lying, but I'm gonna see.
Did you think I'm so easily fooled? What? I've known all along that you might be a snake in the grass. Take this lying, sneaking double agent to the dungeon to keep her under very close watch. Oh, no, I can't even. That makes me so sad. I didn't even want to read it out loud. Thank you for your services. Go now, I will deal with this. You now have to decide what to do about Mervyn's serpent nest. Was Uncle Lauren involved in this, or was it all Lucille? And Charlotte, how much did she know?
So we have a lot of options here. We can execute Lucille only, Lucille and Lauren, execute Lucille, banish the rest, execute the entire family, banish the entire family. I know that only Lucille is guilty. So that's what we're gonna do. With a heavy heart, you sign the orders. That's sad. We are all sad. Except Elodie, who is cheerful as possible. Look at that cheerful face.
Time has slipped by so quickly. Only 2 weeks remain before your birthday celebration and your official coronation as queen. Have you done enough to build a stable Nova? It is traditional for the palace to provide entertainment and refreshment for the common people when a new monarch is crowned. It is a rare opportunity for the poor of the land to dine like nobles. The size and scope of any such feast depends on what expense the royal treasury is able to bear.
So we're going to do a big feast, and then we don't have much money left. 499, it costs 500 lassie to do that. Okay. But we're willful again.
The castle is buzzing with preparation for your upcoming coronation. Ministers press you with details for your favorite flowers and colors and so on. You are happy to collaborate with the designers to ensure you are shown off to the best possible effect. You are still so young, after all. Good design will help a lot in making you look like a queen. Others are more interested in the subject of your marriage. Whomever you decide to marry will be elevated to the highest ranks of the nobility, which could mean a major shift in the balance of power. Therefore, everyone is talking about the top candidates, even though you're under no obligation to marry so young. Tallarist, the Duke of Sedna, is one option. Certainly, he expressed an interest in marrying you earlier. Your union would bring stronger ties to the domain of Talaise and improve the situation among the Ilath border. Then there is Banyan, the Duke of Mari,
A powerful and eligible noble who only about 10 years older than you. Only about 10 years old. He's 33 and you're 14. He's about 20 years older than you. There is Kevin, the Earl of Ew. Although he is only an earl, his family connections could make him politically useful. However, considering the family secret Bryony shared with you, could he ever be a proper husband? There's little Adair, the eventual Duke of Elath, although at 12 he's only a child. At least he's old enough to understand the concept of romance. Some people think you ought to marry Gwynnel's half-brother Anchiet, who hasn't even turned 9 yet. There are 2 or 3 minor earls, about the age of 20, who might be passable alternatives. And of course you could decide to ignore noble traditions entirely and marry a commoner if you were prepared to deal with the uproar. While you will need to marry eventually, you are still very young. You could put this decision off until later. However, a clear succession contributes to the stability of your domain. Are you leaning towards any option? So, we didn't romance a commoner, which is a shame because we met him, but I never saw a chance to meet him again, so I did something wrong, I guess. Talaris is the purple hair guy from Sedna. Banyan is the blonde. Kevin is the red-haired pop collar. Adair is the cute little kid that spilled punch on his shoes. And Anchiet is the 8-year-old that we've never met, and he doesn't have a face. And I guess we didn't dance with the Linley guy because he's not open here. Let's see what happens if we don't marry anybody. You're in no hurry to get married. You have a country to run. I don't know. Let's just see what ending we have. At this time last year, you were celebrating your 14th birthday. You were in the school garden, surrounded by your friends. A teacher brought you tea and cakes, while a wealthy merchant's son wove a crown of flowers for your head. It didn't matter so much you were a princess then. Your title was something for the future. Many of your peers would be duchesses or earls or the like someday, but not then. You were children. Your parents could not attend on the actual day, but they did send wonderful gifts, some for you and some for you to share. And a week later, they came for a visit, and your mother took you through the countryside in a splendid carriage. It was the last time you would ever see her. You wonder if, wherever she is, she can see you now. You are 15 years old, a legal adult. You have worked and studied and suffered and prepared, and now the time has come. You kneel before the priestess, barely hearing her words as she recites the blessings. She calls upon the gods to deliver peace, wisdom, and prosperity to you and through you to all of Nova, and then she calls upon you for your oath of rulership. Will you guide and govern and protect your people to the best of your ability, according to law and custom? I will. Will you, to the best of your power, uphold the ideals of love, honor, justice, and mercy? I will. Lords and ladies assemble, I present to you your undoubted queen who has sworn you her loyalty. You have come to give homage. Will you do the same? One at a time, the head of each duchy approaches your throne and kneels to swear his or her service to you and your heirs. People of Nova, I give you Elodie, daughter of Fidelia, your true sovereign. What say you all? Long live the queen! Thank you, I will. Once his daughter was secure on her throne, Joslin returned to his birthplace to focus on his duties as Duke of Caloris. He was pursued by many women, but showed little interest in remarrying, directing them instead to his brother, the Duke of Mazomba. With the danger of a rogue Lumen weighing on their minds, the squad sent to deal with Lucille, Countess of Nyx, opted to strike quickly and without warning, aiming to eliminate her before she could bring her powers to bear. Kill on sight, infiltrating a ducal stronghold to remove one noble while leaving others unharmed is not a simple task, particularly when the easiest time to catch people off their guard is when they're at family meal or asleep. While Lucille's traumatic death did produce a Lumen crystal to justify Elodie's actions, it was unlikely that her relationship with her uncle and cousins would ever fully recover. Oh.
following Elodie's passionate defense of magic and her victory over the Shantian fleet, the public opinion of Lumens rose to a height that hadn't been seen in 100 years. Young children would dress up and play at being magical warriors of justice. Freed from the need for secrecy, the Duchess Juliana and the Priestess Celine were able to announce their shared magical powers and their love. At Elodie's prompting, the lovers pledged their devotion to each other in a private ceremony, after which Celine retired from the priesthood to accompany her wife to Ursul. Oh! There's Freeny in like a Sailor Moon dress! As neither of them intended to bear children of the body, Juliana made arrangements for her niece Brienne to be declared the next heir to the Duchy of Ursul, as well as the inheritor of her crystal. Brienne's mother, Corisandre, hoped that the training necessary to make her flighty daughter into a future magical girl warrior would keep her out of worse trouble. The loss of their fleet was a terrible setback for Shantia. However, as with a garden weed, if the root is not burned out completely, the infestation may return even worse than before. The king of Shantia had somehow escaped either drowning or capture and returned to his homeland to plot revenge against Nova. Elodie's choice to return all the Shantian prisoners for ransom made it easier for Shantia to restore their military to the level necessary to maintain order, but it would take many years before they could field a conquering horde. Elodie refused to be rushed into marriage, wanting for herself the strong romantic connection her parents had once had. It was many years before she was at last swept off her feet by a young earl with sparkling green eyes and a talent for pastry. He enjoyed surprising the queen with new confections and even prepared their wedding cake. The marriage produced 2 daughters who were perhaps a little spoiled by their parents' indulgent affection. The invention of a printing press sparked the beginning of a new age of literacy and knowledge. No longer were books the sole preserve of the noble and wealthy. Now information and ideas could be easily passed from one place to another. As the birthplace of this invention, Nova was at the center of a storm of change. The new hospital funded by Queen Elodie offered medical services to the common people, but more importantly, allowed doctors and herbalists to come together and share information. Trading knowledge increased skill levels and made better care available to all. Even specialists who catered directly to the elite were benefited by offering their services long enough to learn. That information could now be collected in books and sent around the world. Nova might not benefit directly, but thousands of lives would be saved. Elodie's interest in weapons and dueling led her to invite foreign masters from far and wide to visit Nova and share their secrets. That expertise would also improve the performance of the royal guard and provide security for the crown's heirs, and thus Queen Elodie's legacy stretched into the future. That's amazing. That's wonderful. That was so good. I do think that the Earl of Pastry ending is maybe my happiest ending. I love how happy she sounds. I'm a big sap. Shut up. There's a reason I write romance novels. I'm sad though, because there's supposed to be an ending version where you can show Lucille's journals to Charlotte and prove that she was evil. I don't understand that. So this is with Talaris. Elodie and Talaris carried out a long courtship before finally holding a lavish wedding ceremony to which all the neighboring heads of state were invited. Over the years, they raised 2 daughters and a number of exotic pets from the east. The king consort never tired of giving his girls presents to make them smile. Oh, I like Talaris. He's a sweet boy. This is with Banyan.
Elodie proposed marriage to Banyan, the Duke of Mari, and was eagerly accepted. The marriage was a lavish affair, the groom showing himself off in the best possible romantic light. After the wedding, matters were not always so rosy. The new king had his own political agenda, and maintaining her authority was a constant struggle for Elodie. Aww. There's a couple of Banyan endings, and none of them are really... That one isn't very happy, because he's... And then there's another one where Elodie dresses just sumptuously and puts him in, like, a ballet costume, like a simple costume, and it kind of shows who's the power in the relationship, but he one-ups her by having the ring bearer be his natural son with another woman, so that's not fun. Honestly, I think the best Banyan ending is the one where you're actually, like, threesoming with him and Bryn in terms of romance, not necessarily in terms of sex, but because it seems like he's happier and he's less maneuvering against you because his loyalty to his sister makes him not want to undercut you. Which is sad because I really like, you know, his character. He's a sleazy, manipulative jerk, but I like him. Oh, this is with Kevin. Oh, I just was clicking things. Elodie cautiously broached the subject of marriage to Kevin, the Earl of Eo, indicating she was aware of his circumstances, but that they should not be allowed to continue. Brienne thought the whole thing was a terrible idea, but agreed to help convince her uncle to leave his sister's house. On his wedding day, Kevin spoke as little as possible, even to his new wife. She went to bed that night alone. It took months for him to talk openly about his past, the seduction by his stepfather, the relationship it developed into, the terrible night when his little brother Thaddeus saw what he should not have seen, and then his mother's horrified rejection. Arise divorced her husband Jael at once, ordering him to stay away from Kevin. When he didn't, she had him killed. Was it any wonder that Kevin had deep problems with family, love, and trust? Once he finally gave his full loyalty to Elodie, Kevin's devotion could not be shaken or challenged. Indeed, he would react violently at any threat to her safety and swore that should anything happen to her, he would not live. Oh, that's complicated. I could write it, though. I'm not going to write it, but I bet a good writer could make that work. Poor Kevin. I have a lot of sorrow for him. Years later, when both were adults, Elodie, Queen of Nova, and Adair, Duke of Elath, were married. After an entire week of public celebration set aside for the wedding, and both bride and groom paraded through the capital on fine white horses from the east. Due to his upbringing, Adair was quite used to being told what to do by people older than he was. There was never any doubt who the dominant partner in this relationship would be. Okay. And what about Anstiet? It was something of a private joke between the queen and her friend Gwynelle, Duchess of Sudbury, that one day Elodie would marry Gwynelle's younger half-brother. After all, he wouldn't be eligible for years, and Elodie had the whole world to choose from. But what with one thing and another, the queen never found the right husband. To her surprise, 8 years after she had taken the throne, she discovered that little Anstiet had taken all that joking quite seriously, had in fact fallen in love with her. After that, they had to convince Gwynelle that the wedding invitations weren't a prank. So there's actually a couple more marriage options we didn't open. One of them is Linley, the Duke of Kegel? I'm not sure. But if you dance with him at the gala, then that opens him up as a wedding option. You can marry Talarus's younger brother. Although that one's complicated, because like I said, you have to
accept Tellarus' necklace, and then turn him down badly, and then try to propose to him after losing the poetry of you with a squid, and he accuses you of loose morals, and his brother marries you instead because apparently he has a better sense of humor. You can marry Ignatius, which is Juliana's blue-haired brother and Brienne's father. If you arrange for Ignatius to get divorced from his wife, and I don't know, it seems like there was a couple other things you have to do as well. I think that's it. Let's do a quick check of the wiki, shall we? Please wait. Please wait. This isn't what I want. Oh, here we go. Oh, well, of course you can end up with Bryn. If you dance with her. If Elodie danced with him at the Royal Ball, week 17, Linley of Kegel becomes a potential suitor. There's a dare. Oh, if Aerys initiates a civil war against you and you reach a compromise, then you marry her son Thaddeus. Of course, you can have a romance with Brienne, which we've done. And then you can marry Ivard the Commoner, except I screwed that up somehow. Oh, here it is. Ignatius will reject Elodie, and Elodie will move on to a dashing naval captain unless she resolves things peacefully with Togami. Sorry about that. So okay, that was Long Live the Queen with cheats on. Wow, okay, that was fun. It was really nice to just be able to focus on the story for once and whatever choices I wanted to make without constantly having to, crap, I failed another skill check. Crap, I failed another skill check. Like, that was frustrating. I don't know if you can get achievements with the debugging on. And I don't feel like giving you guys achievement huntings that involve cheats is really helpful. So I will go ahead and I'm going to try to get the rest of the achievements and work out the paths for those. Because I know there's a lot of stuff we still haven't seen. Like marrying Ivard the Commoner. And stuff like that. But I know that some of this stuff is really hard. So I should read off what I'm having trouble with. Hold on, let me pull it up. Okay, here are the achievements I'm missing. Death Seeker, which is 11 different ways to die. Which I think there's a death checklist on the wiki, so I need to look through those. A Divine Omen, you've been blessed by the favor of the cats. I don't know how to get that one. I think a couple of y'all told me in the comments or maybe sent me an email, but it was so long ago. An Unexpected Pairing, you have romanced a commoner. That would be either romancing Ivard or maybe Alice. The Will of the People, you have faced a commoner uprising, which will force me to play, like, deliberately badly, which is gonna be hard because I don't like being a bad queen. Rebellious Province, you have faced a rebellion in Mirva. I think the way you get that one is to, like, execute all of Lucille's family? I'm not sure. Fault Lines, you have caused an earthquake in Nova. So that one is something to do with Togami. If Togami shows up to the palace and Celine is your advisor instead of Juliana, I think she recommends an earthquake. And it, like, eats up the Shanjin army, but it hurts your kingdom way worse than if you'd done nothing at all. Youth's first kiss, you've kissed your fiance before the wedding. That one's easy. That's the new Adair content. So we just need him to come live at the castle with us as our betrothed. An ex-chicken. You have poisoned a defenseless chicken. I don't know what that's about. You have made your cousin into a lumen. I know how to do that. It's new added content. You kill Togami so that he has a crystal materialize. And if you have Lucille as your lumen minister, then it turns out Togami's crystal resonates with Charlotte, which is kind of surprising because he's horrible and evil and she's not, but they do have the same red eyes, so there's that. Family is no defense. You have imprisoned your uncle for acts against the crown. That's if you find early evidence. I don't know how. I'm going to have to look into it. I would have thought we'd been able to on this one. If you find early evidence that Lucille has been the one plotting against you, then it looks like it's just Merva, and so you can accuse your uncle and put him in prison, because Lucille's like, yes, no, he's totally guilty. And then keep your friends close. You have chosen to recruit an advisor of your own free will. I thought that was Lucille. It's not. It's, if Aris leads an uprising and you guys come to a compromise, you can recruit her as an advisor. So that's a lot of playthroughs. Oh my god. I don't know when I'll do them. I'm not promising that they're all going to be this year. but maybe someday. So wow, this has been another Long Live the Queen. And I'm not promising I won't use cheats on those either. We'll see. this was really, like I said, for me, for fun. It was relaxing to be able to stop caring about skills and moods for once and be able to pay attention to just the story. That was really awesome. Don't ever let anyone tell you that cheats don't improve a game, because that was amazing. And there was so much stuff that I hadn't seen before that was really fun. Like, for instance, Sabine saying that our singing is better than hers. That just broke my heart and wanting to sing with us. So yeah, that was Long Live the Queen. And now you know how to put cheats in. So hopefully that can be fun for you guys as well. I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm putting up with my coughing. I'm sorry. I think I'm kind of coming down with something. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.